गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, आई एम डॉक्टर देशमुख अमोल जगन्नाथ, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ प्लांट पैथोलॉजी, कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नवसारी एग्रीकल्चरल यूनिवर्सिटी, वघई, गुजरात. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर इन द कोर्स इंट्रोडक्टरी प्लांट नेमेटोलॉजी ऑफ सेकंड सेमिस्टर BSc ऑनर्स एग्रीकल्चर. द टॉपिक ऑफ द कोर्स इज आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिकली इम्पॉर्टेंट नेमेटोड जनरा with the help of keys and description. Let us start with root knot nematode. Root knot nematode is one of the very important nematode which cause very losses in number of families of hill crop, horticulture crop and forest trees. So let us see some of the keys for the identification of root knot nematode. So root knot nematode is having irregular body female. It is having a perennial pattern at vulval position. So what is perennial pattern? It is a pattern of fine lines like human fingerprint. Just see here. So this is nothing but the annulations or prominent striations which are present at the vulva, and it is useful for differentiating different species of Melodogyne. Excretory pore of the Melodogyne species is at base ventrally. Two lateral lips are wider than that of other four sublateral lips. Juvenile two pudges stylate. In case of esophagus, the esophagus is having large median bulb with short isthmus. Spicule is present in case of male, but bursa are absent. Stylet is strong with rounded knob in case of male, while in case of female it is more slender. So here in this figure you can observe the Melodogyne juvenile anterior, Melodogyne juvenile posterior, mature female anterior, female perennial pattern, male anterior end, male tail, and juvenile full body. So let us see systemic position and some of the symptoms which are produced by root knot nematode. In case of systemic position, it belongs to order Tylenchida, suborder Tylenchina, superfamily Tylenchoidea, family Heterodeiridae, subfamily Melodogynini, genus Melodogyne. There are having number of species, of which Melodogyne incognita, Melodogyne javanica, Melodogyne arenaria and Melodogyne hepla. These are present in Indian condition. So in case of parasitism and habitat, female and third and fourth stage of larvae, these are sedentary endoparasitic one, while second stage larvae and male are migratory one. Host plants, more than 11 families of field and horticulture crops as well as forest crops are affected by this root knot nematode. So the symptoms caused by these root knot nematodes are both above ground symptom as well as below ground symptoms. So in case of above ground symptom, yellowing of leaves, stunted growth, reduced vigor, reduced size and number of fruits in number of crops, and in case of root, there is gall formation or knot formation is observed, and this is due to the nematode and host plant interaction, and it is either multinucleate cell, that is GN cell, or we call it as nurse cell. Second, hypertrophy, that is enlargement of cell can be occurred. It may be hyperplasia, that is multiplication of cell occur. If we have to manage or control the root knot nematode, some of the general strategies we can use, such as 2 to 3 deploying, rotation with non-host crop, application of carbofuran or fumigant at the rate 33 kg per hectare, and use of resistant varieties. So these are some of the control measures we can use. So we will see next nematode genus, cyst nematode. Under cyst nematode, Heterodera species and Globodera species are comes. Why it is called as cyst? Because the female is having a cyst like structure which contain fluid. So these female cysts are generally either these are lemon shape or globular shape with swelling. Vulva is on terminal cone and it is having fenestration. So what is fenestration? There is a pore or opening occurred at vulva. Body is slender in case of male and it is about 1 to 2 millimeter length. In case of larvae, it is about 0.3 to 0.6 millimeter in length. Stylet is short in male than that of female and it is having size 0.02 millimeter long in case of larva. Esophagus is found well developed. It is having median bulb and lobe extending back and overlapping the intestine. Spicule is present near the posterior end of males. So here you can see Heterodera juvenile, juvenile tail, mature cyst, vulval cone with fenestration, male anterior end, male tail, and juvenile full body. So this is all about the key features for identification of cyst nematode. So in case of Heterodeiridae, what is fenestration? So fenestration is nothing but the presence of a pore or opening at vulva. So if the pore is completely present or the vulval slit, then it is called as circumfenestrate. If it is partial, then it is called as ambifenestrate. And if there are two pores are present, which are at two sides of vulval slit, then it is called as bifenestrate. Then in case of Heterodeiridae, round cyst as well as lemon cyst is present, and according to which the genus were differentiated, round cyst or global cyst gives rise to Globodera species, while as lemon cyst gives rise to Heterodera species. So there is also presence of bullae. It is called as a rounded prominent structure which is present just beneath the uterus and it is having underbridge. So these all are the structures or these all are the markings which are too much important for the identification of Heterodera species or cyst nematode. Once again we can see lemon shaped female present in Heterodera species and round or globular shaped female is present in Globodera species. So it is very common and main difference between these two species and in number of exam it can be asked. So let us see some of the information of cyst nematode. So what is cyst? Cyst means any abnormal membranous sac or blister like pouch contain fluid. Systemic position of this cyst nematode is it is of order Tylenchida, सब ऑर्डर टाइलेंचिना, सुपर फैमिली टाइलनकोइडी, फैमिली हेट्रोडेरिडी, सब फैमिली हेट्रोडेरिनी एंड इट इज हैविंग टू जीनस हेट्रोडेरा एंड ग्लोबोडेरा। स्पेसीज ऑफ हेट्रोडेरा कंटेन हेट्रोडेरा एवेनी, इट इज कॉल्ड एज सीरियल सिस नेमेटोड, हेट्रोडेरा जी मेज सिस नेमेटोड, हेट्रोडेरा कजानी पिजन पी सिस नेमेटोड, हेट्रोडेरा ओराइजिकोला राइस सिस नेमेटोड। स्पेसीज ऑफ ग्लोबोडेरा ग्लोबोडेरा रोस्टो चाइनेंसिस एंड ग्लोबोडेरा पेलिडा विच अफेक्ट्स पोटैटो ट्यूबर्स, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज गोल्डन नेमेटोड। होस्ट प्लांट्स पोटैटो टोमैटो ब्रिंजल एंड अदर सोलेनेसियस क्रॉप्स आर मेनली अफेक्टेड बाय दिस सिस नेमेटोड, बट ऑल्सो सम ऑफ द अदर क्रॉप्स सच एज सुगर बीट ओट क्लोवर सोयाबीन एंड क्रूसीफेरस वेजिटेबल्स आर ऑल्सो अफेक्टेड बाय दिस सिस नेमेटोड्स एंड दीज सिस नेमेटोड्स आर मेनली प्रेजेंट इन टेम्परेटेड जोन। सो व्हाट आर द सिम्टम्स कॉज्ड बाय दिस सिस नेमेटोड? इफ देर इज हेट्रोडेरा एंड इट अफेक्ट्स व्हीट एंड बार्ली, देन इट प्रोड्यूसेस येलोइंग ऑफ लीव्स ऑफ प्लांट्स, स्टंटेड ऑफ ग्रोथ ऑफ द प्लांट, रिड्यूस टिलरिंग, देर इज नो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एयर हेड एंड इफ एयर हेड आर फॉर्म दे आर वेरी स्मॉल एंड इट इज नोन एज मोलाई डिसीज। सो इट इज वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डिसीज ऑकर्ड इन इंडिया एंड कॉजेस टू मच मॉनिटरी लॉसेस। सेकंड सिस नेमेटोड इज ग्लोबोडेरा विच अफेक्ट्स पोटैटो। सो इन केस ऑफ पोटैटो इट कॉज स्टंटेड प्लांट्स विथ अनहेल्दी फॉलिएज, प्रीमेच्योर एलिंग ऑफ द प्लांट्स, पुअर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ रूट सिस्टम, रिडक्शन इन साइज एंड नंबर ऑफ ट्यूबर्स, सच प्लांट्स एग्जिबिट टेम्पररी विल्टिंग ड्यूरिंग हॉटर पार्ट ऑफ द डे। सो दीज ऑल आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट सिम्टम्स ऑफ दिस ग्लोबोडेरा और गोल्डन नेमेटोड। दैट इज वाई द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ गोल्डन नेमेटोड इज टू मच इन पोटैटो ग्रोइंग एरियाज ऑफ इंडिया। सो कंट्रोल मैनेजमेंट इन केस ऑफ हेट्रोडेरा, 2 to 3 समर प्लोइंग एट 10 to 15 डेज इंटरवल, रोटेशन विथ नॉन होस्ट क्रॉप सच एज मस्टर्ड एंड चिकपी एंड अप्लाई कार्बोफ्यूरन एट द रेट 1 to 2 kg एक्टिव इन्ग्रीडियंट पर हेक्टर। इन केस ऑफ ग्लोबोडेरा, रोटेशन विथ पी कैबेज कैरोट कॉलीफ्लावर ड्यूरिंग ऑटमन सीजन, ग्रो रेजिस्टेंट वराइटीज ऑफ पोटैटोज लाइक कुफरी स्वर्णा कुफरी थिन मलाई। सो दीज ऑल आर द मैनेजमेंट और सिम्टम्स ऑफ दिस सिस नेमेटोड्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन सिस नेमेटोड्स। सो लेट अस सी नेक्स्ट नेमेटोड, सिट्रस नेमेटोड। सो सिट्रस नेमेटोड इज साइंटिफिकली नोन एज टाइलोन्युक्लस सेमी पेनेट्रांस। सो सेमी पेनेट्रांस मीन्स सेमी एंडोपैरासाइटिक। सो इन केस ऑफ दिस नेमेटोड फीचर्स, बॉडी इज वेरी स्मॉल, फीमेल आर स्वलन, स्टाइलेट इज स्मॉल इन लार्वे एंड मेल्स एंड इट इज वेल डेवलप्ड इन केस ऑफ फीमेल, इसोफेगस विथ डिस्टिंक्ट पोस्टेरियर बल्ब, वल्वा इज प्रोमिनंट एट पोस्टेरियर एंड, एक्सक्रेटरी पोर इज टिपिकली सिचुएटेड एट काउडल रीजन ऑफ दिस टाइलेन्युक्युलस सेमी पेनेट्रेंस। सो इट इज वन ऑफ द एक्सेप्शनल फीचर विच इज प्रेजेंट इन दिस नेमेटोड विच गिव्स राइज टू द सिक्रीशन ऑफ मैट्रिक्स विच रिजर्व्स द एग्स ऑफ फीमेल। सो बुरसा आर एब्सेंट इन मेल, एनस इज ऑल्सो एब्सेंट, मैच्योर फीमेल इज नॉट लाइक किडनी शेप एंड इट इज हैविंग लॉन्ग पॉइंटेड टेल। सो दिस ऑल आर द कैरेक्टर्स और टिपिकल कीज फॉर आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ सिट्रस नेमेटोड। सो हेयर वी कैन सी सोलन फीमेल्स ऑफ सिट्रस नेमेटोड टाइलेन्युक्युलस सेमी पेनेट्रेंस रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम पैरासिटाइज्ड सिट्रस रूट्स। हेयर यू कैन फाइंड द फीमेल एंड द नर्व सेल इन विच द फीमेल सीड हेड इज एम्बेडेड। सो सिट्रस नेमेटोड इट बिलोंग्स टू ऑर्डर टाइलेंचिडा, सब ऑर्डर टाइलेंचिना, सुपर फैमिली Cricornematoidae, family Tylenculidae, subfamily Tylenculinae, genus Tylenculus, species Semiparentus. So it is endoparasitic on roots of citrus and other plants. Mature females are mainly semi-endoparasitic, of which 1/3 portion remains in root cortex, while 2/3 portion or posterior portion remain outside of the root cortex. So symptoms: reduction in growth and vigor of citrus tree, yellowing of foliage occurs, gradual dieback occurs. So what is dieback? It is nothing but death of the plant from upward to downward position. Infected root appear larger and darker due to adherence of soil with gelatinous matrix excreted by adult female. So these gelatinous matrix are mainly excreted by the excretory system, which is present at posterior side of this female nematode of Tylenculus semipenetrans. So it is one of the important point you must have to keep in mind. Cortex of infected root decays and gets flopped off easily. Next nematode is root lesion nematode. It is called as Pratelenchus species. So in case of root lesion nematode, the bulb, its wall and stylet are well developed. Leaf is flattened. You can see here, leaf is flattened. Sexual dimorphism is present. Body length is about 0.4 to 0.8 millimeter. Esophageal glands overlap intestine ventrally. So here overlapping found. Female tail rounded or blunted and rarely pointed. Ovary is monodelphic. Vulva is posteriorly present and it is 1/4 of the body, that is 75 to 80%, and it reduced to form PVS, that is post vulval sac, and male possess bursa. Here you can see entire body of the female, then head B and D, then tail region C and E. So this is all about the key features which are useful for identification of root lesion nematode. You must have to keep in mind. Then these are the nematodes which are endoparasitic or semi-endoparasitic. So here these are the root cortex where nematodes are moving. Then these are the lesions, that is why it is called as root lesion nematode. So systemic position of root lesion nematode includes order Tylenchida, suborder Tylenchina, superfamily Tylenchoidea, family Pratelenchidae, subfamily Pratelenchini, genus Pratelenchus coffee. So it affects citrus, banana, coffee. Pratelenchus G affects maize, and Pratelenchus thorny affects pulses. So it is migratory endoparasite, feeding on root cortex of many crop or plant, and all stages found root or in soil. So symptoms produced by these root lesion nematodes are late emergence of seedling. If germination occurs, it is very less germination, stunted growth of the seedling, necrotic region on the root surface of the seedling, death of the seedling by collision of these root lesions occur, and reduced system or reduced root system may be occur. So what are the control measures? Raise nursery in nematode free soil, or pull and bud infected plants as and when you observe. So these are the management strategies and symptoms produced by this root lesion nematode. So it is also one of the very important nematode. So next one is burrowing nematode. So in case of burrowing nematode, we can found a very short body of the size 0.5 to 0.8 millimeter length. Here is also sexual dimorphism present. Leaf region is rounded in case of female, and it is knob like in case of male, or high lips are present in male. It is having long tail of 2 to 4 micrometer diameter. Tail terminus is bunt in case of female, while in case of male it is pointed. Phasmids are present at mid tail or slightly anterior to mid tail. Weak cephalic sclerotization is present. It is having very short or reduced stylet. Basal knobs are faint or may be absent. It is having reduced esophageal system. Male tail is having bursa. So here you can see Rhodopterus, mature female full body, male anterior, male tail, and female anterior end. So these all are the key features of burrowing nematode. You must have to keep in mind. Then burrowing nematode, scientifically known as Rhodopholus similis, it comes under the order Tylenchida, suborder Tylenchina, superfamily Tylenchoidea, family Pratylenchidae, subfamily Pratylenchini, genus Rhodopholus, species Rhodopholus similis. So it mainly affect on the roots of banana and citrus as endoparasitic nematode. So symptoms caused in banana are poor growth and small fruit size of the plant. Toppling over of the plant may be occurred when high wind pressure is there. Then wounding of the roots resulting in reddish brown cortical lesions internally. So you can see here purple streak on the young roots. The lesions lead to the formation of tunnels and cavities in the roots. The infections spread to young suckers also, in which necrotic tissues develop, and such suckers are useful for transmission of disease from one field to another field. So this is all about burrowing nematode. Then one of the most important nematode is rice stem nematode. It is scientifically known as Dictylacus angustus. So the female of this nematode are slender or highly slightly swollen. These are not fully swollen. Isthmus is not separated from glandular base. So isthmus is reduced one. Glandular bulb not overlap to the intestine. So you can see here it cannot overlap to intestine. Cardia is absent. Ovary is outstretched. You can see ovary, it is too much outstretched. Uterus is having 4 or 5 rows of cells, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stylet is very small and delicate, and it is having delicate knob. Ovary single and prodelphic. Tail is elongate, and male body is more slender than that of female. So slightly swollen female are occurred than that of male. So here you can see entire female body of Dictylacus, and it is Dictylacus stylet region. So these all are the key features for the identification of rice stem nematode. So rice stem nematode, it belongs to order Tylenchida, suborder Tylenchina, superfamily Tylenchoidea, family Anguninidae, subfamily Anguninae, genus Dictylacus, species Angustus, and it causes one of the very important disease in rice, and it is called as Oophra disease. The symptoms of Oophra diseases are at vegetative phase and at reproductive phase. So at two phases the symptoms are occurred. At vegetative phase, yellowing or white splash pattern of leaf sheath where margin become consolidated. Later splash pattern develop brown stains and internodes and stem turn black. At the reproductive phase, the nematode collects around the floral primordia and feed upon the developing earheads. Earheads emerged and become crinkled or twisted with empty spikelets. Such type of symptoms are called as ripe ophthalmia. If earhead does not emerge at all, then it is called as swollen ophthalmia. So these two are the important symptoms of this rice stem nematode. One must have to keep in mind. Let us see next nematode, that is reniform nematode. It is called as Rotulinculus reniformis scientifically. So mature female are kidney shaped with pointed tail. It is having a tail pointed. Basal gland overlap intestine very long. So the basal knob of esophagus, it overlap to the intestine very longly in case of male as well as female. Here you can see in the case of male, the basal knob is projected too much. Dorso esophageal gland orifice is having about the size 13 to 33 micrometer from stylet, and that is why this situation is occurred. Body is vermiform in case of male, spiral to C-shaped. Phasmids are present at the mid tail. Male are vermiform. Anterior end is reduced. Bursa difficult to see, not quite to the tail. There are four lateral lines are present. Median bulb with strong valve. So it is having median bulb and valve present. It is a strong, and two genital branches are present in case of female. So here you can see Rotulinculus female protruding from root tissue, and male full body and tail region of the male, where bursa present here, but it is difficult to see in other. So reniform nematode belongs to order Tylenchida, suborder Tylenchina, superfamily Hoplolamoidea, family Hoplolamidae, subfamily Hoplolaminae, genus Rotulinculus, species reniformis. So the female are semi-endoparasitic on many plants. These reniform nematode produce number of symptoms in number of plants, such as yellowing of leaves, delayed germination, reduced plant growth and vigor, stunted growth of the plant, browning of roots. Young and tender plants are more vulnerable to these nematode attack. That is, reniform nematode are attacking mainly on young and tender plants. So these all are about the reniform nematode, key features of identification and symptoms they produced. Next, spiral nematode. So spiral nematode scientifically known as Helicotylenchus species. So helical itself indicates the shape of the nematode is spiral. So glandular bulb overlap intestine ventrally. Tail is very short and it is more curved dorsally. So you can see dorsally it is curved. Phasmids are present. Dorso esophageal gland orifice often far from the stylet. So it is far away from the stylet and it is about 6 to 16 micrometer in length. Body is spiral to straight. Labial region is rounded or flattened or blunt. Four lines in lateral fields. Two genital branches are present. Stylet average size is about 25 micrometer. Ovaries are present two in numbers, that is why diadelphic in nature. And body of the male is arcuate to C-shaped when relaxed. Male tail is having short bursa. So here you can see full body of spiral nematode. Then this is stylet, this is caudal regions. So irregular tail projections you can see in these two figures. Tail with non-annulated ventral projection you can see here. So these all are the key features of this spiral nematode for the identification. You must have to keep in mind. So spiral nematode, it is scientifically known as Helicotylenchus species. It belongs to order Tylenchida, suborder Tylenchina, superfamily Tylenchoidae, family Hoplolamidae, subfamily Rotelenchoidinae, genus Helicotylenchus. These are endoparasitic and ectoparasitic on many plants. The nematodes attack mainly on root cortex and produce necrotic lesions. So these are the symptoms produced by this spiral nematode in number of crops. So next is dagger nematode. It is Zipinema species. So it is one of the very important nematode, as it is the nematode which is useful as a vector for transmitting viruses. So here you can see the key feature is mainly stylet. Stylet is very long, straight, tapering to a long slender point with long extension. Body is very long. Stylet extension with sclerotized basal flanks. So there is basal flanks are present. So knob are absent. So stylet knob are replaced by these basal flanges. Guiding ring is present in case of stylet at their base. So it is one of the key feature of this nematode. Ovary is monodelphic or didelphic, tail bluntly rounded. Here you can see males extremely rare, not essential for production reproduction. Female are cylindrical one with curvature at caudal region. So here you can see Zipinema full body, head with stylet and guiding ring, vulval region and tail region. So these all are the very important features for identification of dagger nematode. So dagger nematode, it is scientifically known as Zipinema. It belongs to order Dorylamida, suborder Dorylamina, superfamily Dorylamoidae, family Longidoridae, subfamily Zipinemae, genus Zipinema. So it is a migratory ectoparasite. So symptoms, it attacks on the root system and root shows necrosis, lack of laterals, terminal swelling may occurs or root galling may occurs, and it act as a vector to transmit grip and leaf virus disease. So dear students, we have studied the key features which are useful for the identification of number of important genus. So you must have to keep in mind all the key features. So some of the key features I want to state here, that such as the stylet. So stylet with having guiding ring near the base or near the tip. Stoma with having stylet or non-stylet. So different types of esophagus such as monopartite, bipartite, tripartite and fourpartite. So here you can see in case of tripartite, median bulb is absent, while in case of fourpartite, median bulb is present. So these two types of nematodes are not having stylet. Here it is stylet present. So these are basically non-parasitic nematode. So these types of key features are too much important for the identification of different genus. So female nematode body types are also one of the important feature we must have to keep in mind. So here you can see swollen female, globule or globose female, sacket female or cylindrical type female. So these all are the key features which are too much important one. So dear students, we have seen today the number of key features, the scientific position or of economically important genera which are included in our syllabus. So if you have any doubt, if you have any suggestion, or if any mistake I have made during presentation, you must have to comment so that I will incorporate in next lecture series. Thank you so much.